Hello, everyone, and welcome to part 3 of this 3-part video on search syntax in Dialog. In the first 2 parts, we looked at some of Dialog's built-in default search tools, how they work on their own, and how you can turn them off for exact searching. And we've looked in some detail at an important tool called truncation. In this last part, we'll talk about how to combine search terms in Dialog, either with Boolean operators or by using proximity connectors, called near and pre, to take control of how close together you want your terms to be. So let's get started. So now we've talked about what happens when you search for a word in Dialog. Now let's turn to the ways we can combine search words, starting with the Boolean operators. Dialog uses all 3 of the Boolean operators, AND, OR, and NOT, and these work just as you would expect. If you search for food and nutrition, you'll only get records that contain both of those terms. If you search for food or nutrition, you'll get any record that has either one of those terms. You can also use the NOT connector to prevent retrieving records that contain a particular word so that you can block out a lot of records that you expect will be unwanted, as in this example. A few tips about the Boolean operators. AND is actually applied automatically by the search engine if you have 2 words next to each other with no kind of connector between them and no quotation marks. So simply typing apple orange will actually work the same in the search engine as apple and orange. Some people like to use this default behavior, what we call the implied AND, to save themselves the extra keystrokes of typing the word AND in between words. Personally, I like to type out the AND so that I can see what the search is doing, but you have this choice. With OR, it's always a good idea to put parentheses around the group of terms that you're ORing together, as you can see here. It's not strictly necessary if your whole search statement is something like dog or cat, but it's a good search habit to always use parentheses with OR because it is critical if you're doing a search that combines the OR operator with other connectors such as AND or NOT, as we'll see in the next slide. As to the NOT operator, I might suggest you use this with some caution, only because it might block out some records that you do want, but there are situations where you can decide that the NOT connector is exactly what you need. Here you see some examples of the correct way to use parentheses in a search where you're using both OR and some other connectors such as AND. If you always put the parentheses around any group of terms that you're combining with OR, then you'll have no problems adding other connectors to your search. Moving beyond the Boolean operators, there may be times when combining your terms with AND may be too broad. You might get records, for example, where your first search term is in the title and your second term is there, but it's used only once near the end of a full text record, so that while both terms are present, they're really not used in any relation to each other. For this reason, you may want to take control over how close together your search terms must appear, or maybe even what order they're in. And that's where the proximity connectors come in. And we have 2 of them, called near and pre. We'll start with near, which is the more commonly used. If you type 2 terms with the word near in between, you'll get any records that have both of those terms in any order with up to 4 words in between them. But most of the time, the near connector is used in combination with a number, which can be either bigger or smaller than 4, and you'd use this format here, n/followed by a number. If we use n/3, here are some examples of what would be retrieved. The number can be 0, and technically there's no limit to how high the number can be, but at very high numbers, it's less effective for your purposes, so that at some point, rather than using, say, n/150, it just makes more sense to use AND. As a practical matter, near works best with smaller numbers like 3 or 5, or perhaps 10 or 20, so that you'll have a more meaningful effect in making sure the terms are used in relation to the same topic. But you can play around with these numbers. If you're using n/5, for example, you might want to see if you get tighter relevance by changing it to n/3, Or if you want more hits and broader results, you can try N/10 and see what works best for you. This is a great example of a variable that you can experiment with in a dialog search. So with the near connector, you can control how close together you want your terms to be, but there may be times when you also want to take control of what order the words appear in, and that's where you would use the pre connector. With the near connector, the terms on either side of near can be in any order, but with pre, they must be in the same order that you've put them in your search statement. So pre, as you see here, will generally get fewer hits than near, but at times, this will be part of what you're trying to do. As with near, you'll most often abbreviate pre with just the first letter, P, followed by a slash and then a number. And there's a special use case I'd like to show you for pre/0 or P/0, and that is to use P/0 to connect the words in a phrase as an alternative to putting the whole phrase in quotation marks. And here's why. You might want to search for a phrase with certain words in an exact order, but still want to allow for one or more words to be plural, or for words to have British or American spellings, or maybe for an adjective to be in different forms, like tall, taller, tallest. And using quotation marks would not allow those variations, but using P/0 between the words would. So in this example, if you're searching for high estrogen level, but you'd also want to get higher or highest estrogen level, or if you'd want to get the plural levels as well as level, or if you want either of the spellings of the word estrogen, then this is how you would do it. Using high, P/0, estrogen, P/0, level. This serves the real purpose of a phrase search without causing you to miss records that use variant forms of the words that you would still want. So P/0 is quite often a useful option to keep in mind. So that's it. In this video, you've learned about each of these three default search functions. You've learned how to search for exact terms and phrases, how to search using truncation, and how to combine terms using either the Boolean operators or the proximity connectors near and pre. I hope you found this helpful. If you'd like more information, here are some links to additional resources. If you have any questions or need some help, feel free to call us at these numbers, or you can email the help desk at customer@dialog.com. Thanks for using Dialog, and enjoy the rest of your day.